What if I tell you that the girl you are listening to right now is an astrologer? Yes, you all heard it right. And today, on this very stage, I am going to predict your future, my friend. So a year or maybe 6 months from now, you all will have taller buildings but shorter temples. Wider freeways but narrower viewpoints. You'll have a lot of degrees but no sense. You'll multiply your possessions but reduce your values. You know why? Because you will modernize. And in this ongoing modern world, I stand before you as an Indian. An Indian who is apprehensive to talk in her very own native language, Hindi. Yes, ma'am, I'm an Indian who gets up in the morning and the first thing that I do rather than worship the God is check my Instagram notifications. I am an Indian whose traditions have been killed under the label of modernity, and I'm pretty sure half of us have been doing just the same thing. You know why? Because we are modern, isn't it? We all live in a modern world, or at least we pretend to believe that we are. We tend to shun anything or everything that does not fit our accepted definition of modernity by calling it traditional or orthodox. Before I move further, I'd like you all to understand that when I talk about tradition and modernity, I have nothing to do with clothes. Your choice between a sari and a skirt does not define who you are at all. For me, tradition is the illusion of permanence. It's about our ethics, values, morals, culture, and language. Talking about language, while I was preparing for this very competition, a piece of paper was handed over to me by my teacher on which the rules and regulations of the competition were written. While I was going through that paper, an irony struck into my head. We were supposed to talk about modernity posing a threat to Indian traditions in a language that is not even native to us. And over that, we were not even allowed to use any other language than English. Funny, right? But on a serious note, this is the extent to which modernity has already finished our Indian traditions. We Indians have been very good at aping the West just because we thought that our traditions will land us nowhere, while modernity will help us to develop. Whenever we've encountered any kind of problem, we've always copied the West. Why? Because we thought that the West were better, they are modern, they are cool, and hence they are right. That is the reason why a person named Kapil Sibal screwed the entire Indian traditional education system by introducing the CCE only because the Americans followed it, and he thought it was modern and will help the Indian children to develop. Look how developed we are, sir. Just like Americans, our day starts with good mornings and ends with good night. Our birthdays are no more family gatherings. They are more of party with friends. Our identity is now from the West. We're not just losing our traditions, my friends. We're losing our very own identity. And let me tell you all, which is modernity, we'll be creating a youth without heroism, ages without wisdom, and life without grandeur. At last, I'd like to conclude by saying that it's okay to be modern in the 21st century. Rather, I'd say it's very important to be modern, but not at the stake of our Indian traditions. Please let me be an Indian who's not ashamed, rather proud of her traditions, or at least let me be an Indian who remembers what her traditions are. Thank you very much.